Chesterfield, Chesterfield always takes first place. That mile or mile tobacco never leaves an aftertaste.
So open the pack, give them a smell,
then you'll smoke them.
Someone waits for me.
This is Ken Carpenter welcoming you to the Bing Crosby Show for Chesterfield, produced and transcribed in Hollywood with John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Judge Collins of the Bears, and Bing's guest, Mr. Fred Astaire. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present Gary Crosby's father, Mr. Music.
Thank you. Now, wait a minute, Ken. Thank you a lot, but
I really think, Ken, the folks heard enough about Mr. Music on the show last week. Now,
Bing, that was only the beginning.
Oh, no.
Well, the month of January is here, and letters and telegrams are pouring in from all over the country congratulating you on your 20 years in show business.
No kidding.
Why, sure. Not only that, carrier pigeons are arriving by the thousands every day with messages.
Well, why carrier pigeons with messages?
Well, Bing, what a lot of the folks have to say just can't be sent through the mail.
I'll bet Hope sat on the eggs that hatched those pigeons.
I wouldn't accuse Bob of that.
No, I'll retract that. I must, because Bob doesn't sit in one place long enough to hatch anything. Ken, whether the messages are good or bad, they are all in the beloved American tradition.
That's right.
I tell you, it's wonderful living in a country where even the president can say what he thinks. Don't say it with ink.
No. Would you like to see some of the messages, Bing?
Well, certainly.
Here's a telegram from Benny Stubeck in Spokane, Washington.
Oh, good old Benny. Is he still running the pool hall up there?
Apparently.
Yeah?
It says, now that you've been chosen Mr. Music, I would like to join in the celebration and mark your old account paid.
Isn't that sweet of Benny? Yes, he thinks of everything.
Here's a P.S. I'm putting your brother Everett's bill in the hands of a collection agency.
Listen, he might as well tear that one up, too.
Well, Bing, here's another wire. I don't know. I don't think you'll care too much for this one.
I can take it.
It says, Bing Crosby, Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
Why all this hullabaloo about you? I got bigger in 6 weeks than you did in 20 years.
Who's that from?
It's signed The Thing.
All right. Okay, Ken. Now read me some of the good ones.
Those are the good ones.
Oh. Well, I better go to singing then. Our opening number is Life is So Peculiar, which oddly enough is from a Paramount picture called Mr. Music. Oh, life is so peculiar. You get so wet in the rain. You get so warm in the sunshine, but it doesn't pay to complain. When I get up each morning, there's nothing to breathe but air. When I look in the mirror, there's nothing to comb but hair. When I sit down to breakfast, why do you laugh? Life is so peculiar, but you can't stay home and brood.
Yes, life. It's so peculiar.
The desert's only got some sand. The ocean's loaded with water.
You never know where you stand.
When I go out to dinner, there's nothing to wear but clothes.
When I get sleepy, nothing to do but doze.
And whenever I get thirsty, there's nothing to do but drink.
Oh, life is so peculiar that it makes you stop and think.
Oh, life is so peculiar.
A bird can usually sing. A pearl is made by an oyster.
Man, you can't be sure of a thing. When I
get tired of resting.
There's nothing to do but walk.
And when I don't care to listen,
there's nothing to do but talk.
When I'm up there buzzing around in my airplane,
there's nothing to do but fly. Life is so peculiar and I often wonder why. Yes, life is so peculiar.
A fork belongs with a knife. Corned beef is lost without cabbage. A husband should have a wife.
Well, you know that life is so peculiar, but as everybody says, that's life, that's life.
Well, ain't it a mess?
That's life.
Bing, and boys and girls.
We thank you, Mr. Cartman. Now, should we spread the good word about those ever-loving Chesterfields, huh?
I'm delighted, Bing, although I do think better tasting is a bit more apropos than ever-loving.
Well, I sometimes get carried away when I'm talking about my favorite cigarette. But anyway, folks, ever-loving, better tasting Chesterfield is the only cigarette that combines for you mildness with no unpleasant aftertaste.
Yes, that's absolutely right, friends. But you can prove it yourself. Buy a pack of Chesterfields. Then open it and enjoy that delicate, milder Chesterfield aroma. Compared with the brand you've been smoking, and you'll find Chesterfields are milder.
And tobaccos that smell milder smoke milder. You light a Chesterfield, and you see how true that is. Chesterfields do smoke milder.
You'll notice, too, that they leave no unpleasant aftertaste. That fact has been confirmed by the country's first and only cigarette taste panel.
So always buy Chesterfield, the only cigarette that combines mildness with no unpleasant aftertaste. Here's a song written by Calmar and Ruby. It's been revived in the last few weeks, till it's now, I think, number one or two or three. Maybe I'm right, and maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm weak, maybe I'm strong. But nevertheless, I'm in love with you. Maybe I'll win, and maybe I'll lose. Maybe I'm in for crying the blues. But nevertheless, I'm in love with you. Somehow I know at a glance the terrible chances I'm taking. Fine at the start, then left with a heart that is breaking. Maybe I'll live life of regret, and maybe I'll give much more than I'll get, but nevertheless, I'm in love with you. Maybe I'll live a life of regret. Maybe I'll give much more than I'll get. But nevertheless, I'm in love.
Might as well confess it.
I'm in love with you.
The time now approacheth where we usher in our visiting personality of the evening. Tonight we're setting sort of a precedent here by bouncing right back with a guest star whose last appearance was Such a smash that fan mail poured in from all over the country requesting a return engagement of this great artist.
Bing, are you talking about Fred Astaire?
That's the boy.
Oh, but last time Fred Astaire was with us was 2 years ago. Is that bouncing right back?
Well, on our lackadaisical type program, it is, yes.
Well, Bing, Don't quibble.
Ladies and gentlemen, in answer to your thousands of insistent letters requesting his immediate return, we bring you once again the nimble-witted, nimble-footed Fred Astaire.
Thank you, Bing. Thank you.
Fred, here we are again.
I know. And I feel like a pest bouncing right back like this.
Oh, now, don't be silly. We can't get enough of you.
But, Bing, I was here only 2 years ago.
Well, that's what you call showmanship, Fred. You were on, you were good, so we grab you right back while you're hot.
I still think we should have waited another week.
What, and let you get cold?
Just so I don't get overbearing.
Oh, I see.
I'd hate to be one of those guys you turn on your radio every 2 years and there he is.
Oh, now, Fred.
One Arthur Godfrey is enough.
Now, Sir Fred, as far as we're concerned, you'll never wear out your welcome here.
Oh, it's not me. You're just enthusiastic about dancing. I can tell.
How can you tell?
By your clothes.
How do you mean that?
You're always dressed like you're on your way to a square dance.
Either a square dance or a snipe hunt. I'm ready for it. Or a duck blind. Anything you want.
Bing.
What?
Is that on the level about that fan mail?
What I said about you up there? Yes, the folks demanded you. Thousands of fans wrote in. They absolutely demanded your return.
Then why'd you wait 2 years?
Because I don't like people telling me what to do.
Say, you are a headstrong boy.
Well, as a boy, I had the strongest head in Spokane.
You'd have to hold up those ears.
Now, just a minute. You may, man, Fred. We're too classy, you and I. We shouldn't be doing this. We have too much soigneur to stand here and resort to this rowdy, rugged type of dialogue. It isn't for us at all. It's for Hope and those kind of people. Jerry Lewis.
I was only kidding, Bing, really.
When you talk like that, you make me sorry I waited so long to bring you back.
Well, Bing, you always were a procrastinator.
Yeah, I always used to be known as that. What was I?
Procrastinate.
Well, I turned over a new leaf. I don't procrastinate anymore. I don't put things off like I used to.
No.
No, I've reformed.
Give me a for instance.
Well, for instance, this afternoon I attended to some work that I've been meaning to do on my car.
Finally put on your 1950 plates, huh?
No, I scraped that NRA sticker off the windshield. That thing has been bothering me.
Say, you're really getting caught up.
Yeah, now I'm all ready to go on that trip. You know, the one I've been postponing for so long.
What trip?
Dixie and I are going on our honeymoon.
Well, congratulations.
Would you like to go along with us?
On your honeymoon?
Yeah.
Wouldn't I be in the way?
Not at all. You can play with the kids. You'd make a nice fifth for basketball.
Well, okay. Tie a pair of sneakers on the back of the car and count me in.
Oh, you are a pal.
You're my buddy, Bing. You know, in our house, you're our favorite radio personality.
Hmm. You listen to the program regularly?
Every 2 years.
Well, you never were much of a fella to form habits, were you?
But I want to tell you one thing, Bing. I saw Mr. Music and I enjoyed it very much.
Well, on behalf of the large and talented cast in Mr. Music, I thank you very much.
And Bing, I think it's wonderful that ASCAP, the American Society of Authors, Composers, and Publishers, has bestowed upon you the title of Mr. Music of Show Business. And furthermore, I understand the entire month of January is being dedicated to you.
Well, frankly, Fred, I'm just a little embarrassed about that.
What do you mean, embarrassed? I heard that originally they were going to make it the month of February, but you put up a terrible squawk because it only has 28 days.
I wasn't complaining about that. I just didn't feel right moving in on Washington and Lincoln like.
Why not? You all came up together. What are you going to call this month? Binguary?
No, it's a good idea. You know, the way they explained the idea to me was that they hoped that when people thought of January, they'd think of me.
Well, frankly, Bing, I have an Esquire calendar, and when I think of January, I'm not thinking of you.
Well, you've never seen me in my new muncing wear with the drawstring.
You know, it's hard to believe you're celebrating your 20th year in show business. It doesn't seem you've been around that long, does it?
Well, it wasn't so long ago I saw you dance for the first time.
Oh, yes, it was.
Oh, it was. And I remember when it was Fred and Adele Astaire.
I was a gay young boy.
Oh, you were a handsome devil. You had everything. Youth, charm, looks. Always puzzled me, though.
What?
All that going for you and you were out dancing with your sister.
Well, at least it wasn't my brother.
Well, everything.
Remember, Bing, Adele wasn't my only partner.
No, that's right.
Well, we split up when she got married.
Well, see, I wanted to ask you something about that, too, Fred. Adele was so talented and attractive. When she left, I imagine lots of trouble, huh? Getting a beautiful partner. I mean, for a guy like you.
What do you mean, for a guy like me?
Well, you know, a guy that hangs out with his sister.
While we're discussing family life,
yes.
Right here, I'd like to say, never have I worked with my son.
Fred, now that we're fortunate enough to have you here, what would you like to do to entertain our listeners?
Well, let's see. I dance.
Well, that doesn't work too good for radio. Dancing's great, Fred, but if they ever invented something where people could see you as well as hear you.
You mean television?
Quiet. We've been telling our listeners that the television is still on the drawing board.
Bing, your listeners must lead a pretty sheltered life.
Oh, most of them are on the lam. Folks, Fred and I have a little special arrangement here of a big hit tune, which we now submit for your approval. Are you ready, Fred?
Ready.
John Scott, let's have it.
While we were walking down the beach one bright and sunny day, we saw a great big wooden box a-floating in the bay. We pulled it out and opened it up, and much to our surprise, oh, we discovered a right before our eyes.
Yes, they discovered a right before their eyes, a genuine real life before their very eyes.
I thought I'd take it home with me and teach it how to sing. We'd go on television then, the team of Thing and Bing. We practiced McNamara's band and dear old Donegal. But I couldn't sing with that. It had no voice at all.
He couldn't sing with that. It had no voice at all.
I took it to my studio to teach it how to dance. To polka, waltz, and jitterbug, I gave it every chance. I taught it every step I knew, its training was complete. And then I noticed that it hadn't any feet.
He couldn't dance with it. It hadn't any feet.
I took it out to Pittsburgh then to join the Pirates team. And every time it came to bat, showed a lot of steam. Four times it circled the bases, but it made no score at all. That silly son of a forgot to hit the ball.
That silly son of a forgot to hit the ball.
I introduced it to my friends, this mystifying pet. It soon became the darling of the international set. I said to Rita Hayworth, is it beast or is it man? She said, I can't figure that. But maybe Allie can.
Maybe Allie can. He made a jump, but maybe Allie can.
We put it back into the box and tied it tight with rope. And then we sent it POD to Mr. Robert Hope. Oh, how we'd like to be on hand to watch the luckless goof. When that sees that, he'll really hit the roof.
When that sees that, he'll blow a stop, he'll call a cop and really hit the roof.
Well, I guess we took care of that thing, huh?
We sure did, old thing. But, Bing, now that you're celebrating your 20th anniversary, I think the folks would like to hear one of your old songs. I would.
What, for instance, do you think they'd like to hear?
Just One More Chance.
Well, I tell you, if John Scott can take the old arrangement and slide it down about four tones, I may be able to handle it without popping a gasket.
To prove it, you alone I care for. Each night I say a little prayer for just one more chance, just one more night to taste those kisses that enchant me. I'd want no others if you'd grant me just one more chance. I've learned the meaning of repentance. Now you're the jury at my trial. I know that I should serve my sentence. Still I'm hoping all the while you'll give me just one more word. I said that I was glad to start out, but now I'm back to cry my heart out for just one more chance. I've learned the meaning of repentance. Now you're the jury at my trial. I know that I should serve my sentence. Still I'm hoping all the while you'll give me just one more word. I said that I was glad to start out, but now I'm back to cry my heart out for just one more chance.
Thank you.
Very, very good, Bing. You never sang that song better.
Ken, this is the start of the new year now. Let's not start out by conning.
Okay. Bing, this being the start of the new year, I think we should go all out to remind the folks what a wonderful cigarette Chesterfield is.
Now, you can count me in, Ken, because nothing makes me happier than to see a smoker change over to Chesterfield.
And now's the time to do it, friends. Once you get a pack of Chesterfields, then open them, smell them, and smoke them. You'll convince yourself they're milder.
And once you start smoking them, you'll find milder Chesterfields leave no unpleasant aftertaste.
Yes, that fact has been confirmed by the country's first and only cigarette taste panel. So make 1951 the year you change to better tasting Chesterfields, the only cigarette that combines for you mildness with no unpleasant aftertaste.
Always buy Chesterfields. They satisfy.
Chesterfield always takes first place. That milder, mild tobacco never leaves an aftertaste.
So open the pack, give them a smell,
then you'll smoke them.
Isn't that cute?
Another song.
where the sea is dark and cold. My love has gone, and our dreams grow old. There'll be no tears. There'll be no regretting. Will she remember me? Will she forget? I'll send a thousand flowers when the trade winds blow.
Of acknowledgments to supporting artists. That was Miss Lulie Jean Norman singing out there beyond the reef, and Danny Stewart was on the steel guitar. And that song certainly gives me the old wanderlust. I may jump on a freighter in the morning if the Southern Star's in the harbor down there and leave for the Southern Seas.
I'll go with you. It'll be a good place to hide until Bing Crosby month blows over.
You bring some trinkets, I'll bring the dice, and my ukulele will be a riot down there.
But really, Bing, I do want to offer my congratulations and best wishes for next Wednesday, which will be Bing's Day all over the country.
What's this Bing's Day now?
Why, it's in your honor.
Get out.
Next Wednesday, they'll be dancing in the streets, balloon ascensions, one-cent sales, cornerstone layings, grass fires, smog protest meetings. And to top off the whole thing, thousands of carrier pigeons flying in formation are going to spell out Bing Crosby.
In the sky?
In the sky, on the ground, all over.
Isn't this thrilling?
Who's going to help you celebrate Bing's Day on your program next week?
Well, next week, Fred, our guests are going to be Bob Hope and Bob Crosby.
Well, that's better than a grass fire.
Yeah. Better than the pigeons, too. Well, we're going to have just a lot of fun. Thanks, Fred, for dropping in, huh?
It was really jolly, Bing. Good night.
Good night, Fred, folks. See you next week for Chesterfield, the best cigarette for you to smoke.
This is Sherman Billingsley reporting from my store club in New York. You know, our number one cigarette is Chesterfield. And when customers ask for a long cigarette, I always recommend Fatima. It says right on the gold and yellow package, they're extra mild. And they sure are. At the Stork Club, we only recommend the best. Number one, Chesterfield. And King Size Fatima, the best of all long cigarettes.
The Bing Crosby Show, presented by Chesterfield, was produced and transcribed in Hollywood by Bill Morrow and Myrtle McKenzie. Fred Astaire will soon be seen with Jane Powell in the Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer Technicolor musical, Royal Wedding. Tune in next week and hear Bing and his guests, Bob Hope and Bob Crosby.